So Ritu, second, actually the first movie of the day was Gringo. We had to actually make a drive to go and see this one. And let's kick off with the rating. What did you think?
Rating, I would give it a 7.
Okay.
I quite enjoyed the movie. Gringo essentially is a foreigner in Spanish-speaking countries, especially an American who's not a Hispanic or a Latino. And the equivalent is, say for example, Gualo in Hong Kong. So this is about this guy. Would you care to elaborate on the plot? So
David Oyelowo is this guy who's meek, mild, straight. He always does the right thing.
Right.
And he's married to Thandi Newton, who, and we find out within the first minutes that he's way over in his head in terms of loans and finances. And his accountant also lets slip that his job may possibly be at risk because his the firm he works for is probably going to get merged with someone, another one.
Right.
Now, he thinks he's safe because he's working with his friend. His friend is Joel Edgerton, who's, I mean, you've seen him in multiple movies, Star Wars, etc., including the disastrous one we saw a few weekends back, which is Red Sparrow.
That's right.
So Joel Edgerton is there. And the other president, by the way, is Charlize Theron.
Hmm.
I mean, in a kick-ass, ball-busting kind of a role.
Right.
So that was fun. Now, can he trust his boss? Will his boss have his back?
Right.
And there's this little matter, which is what he basically looks after. There's this little matter of some inventory loss in Mexico, in the factory that they have in Mexico. And now both his presidents want to come with him as he makes his next inventory check.
Right.
And then there's this little subplot involving Amanda Seyfried, who's along with her boyfriend, also going to Mexico. Apparently they have free tickets just to pick up something that her boyfriend's friend wants them to pick up. So what is happening? And it's a pharma company, as an aside, if that gives you any hints. So in all of this chaos, the plot kind of moves on.
Right.
And what I loved about the movie, so my rating, by the way, is going to be higher than yours.
Okay.
I'm going to go with an 8.
Hmm.
Just because I thought it was so unexpected, the way the plot developed, you couldn't predict the next scene from the first.
Right.
And I thought Charlize Theron was awesome in the film.
Absolutely.
In the sense of the way she came on. But the piece de resistance was David Oyelowo. Because you're very used to him. I mean, he's the guy, for example, who was there in Jack Reacher. He's the cop. And you're very used to him in serious, measured roles. And here he just lets go. It is fabulous to watch him in this movie. So, and various other subplots that I don't even want to begin getting into because I don't want to give any spoilers, but such unexpected angles come up that it's fabulous for me.
Yeah, and they threw in bits about God, believing in God.
Is it right or is it wrong, or is it, do you believe in God or you do you not?
Amanda Seyfried going with, you know, I have good instincts.
Yeah, I have good instincts, etc. So,
it was really.
It was great
well
fun
together.
In that sense. So, well put together, great fun, lots of jokes, lots of moments of laugh out loud.
Yes.
And so, for me, Gringo really worked as a package. Hats off to Nash Edgerton, by the way, who's Joel Edgerton's brother, who's made the film.
Correct.
I think great film. Enjoy.